My name is Dr. V.K. Jagnany, myself working at Agrasen Hirdayalay, which is my own setup at Ranchi. We do work in cardiology, diabetology, and clinical cardiology. Well, today we are going to talk about pregnancy and exercise. We all know that pregnancy is a complex physiological state which involves a lot of hormonal changes, the physical changes in the body. Along with that, the mental changes are also involved. A lady, when gets pregnant, we need to understand that to keep her body fit as well as for good fetal growth, she should exercise regularly. We all know that exercise must be done anyway, whether a person is pregnant or not. So if somebody is exercising regularly, nothing like it. But if not, we should definitely start exercise during pregnancy. How do we start? If we have not been exercising since beginning, we need to start slow. It should be moderate intensity, short duration, and we should learn to listen to the body. Relaxation is important part of exercise. We should not go for vigorous exercises or an exercise which involves lot of turning, twisting, specifically in the abdominal part of the body. We should definitely not go for weight lifting specifically above the head. The exercise also changes as the pregnancy progresses. Say in first trimester we can go for routine exercises, but in second and third trimester we should avoid exercise which involves prolonged lying down. Why? Because that will affect the growth of the fetus which is being there in the womb. Also, along with the exercise which is being done during pregnancy, we need to take care of good nutrition. What do we mean by that? Plenty of fluids. Why? Because thirst lags behind the requirement of the fluid in the body. So what do we want is that we should frequently take small fluid intakes, specifically water and juices. We should avoid caffeinated drinks and alcoholic drinks. We should eat healthy diet which includes lots of fruits and fresh vegetables. While exercising, we also need to understand that we should use sports wear which is loose and comfortable and cotton clothing. Once we are doing regular exercises, what are the exercises which we can do during pregnancy? Simple walking is simplest thing. Along with that, water exercises, yoga, cycling, all these can also be included. Aerobics with low impact exercises are also very much acceptable. We should also understand that when not to exercise. If there is any medical condition which limits our exercise, or everything was normal but with exercise during pregnancy we find that some medical problem has come up, we should immediately stop the exercise, consult a qualified clinician and then go for the exercise as recommended by the clinician. Also, if there is any cardiac condition which compromises the hemodynamic circulation, or there is severe anemia, or there is pulmonary hypertension, or there is respiratory disease, there is peripheral arterial disease, all these are conditions where we should not exercise. What are the conditions where exercising, what are the warning signs which we should understand that this is the time to stop the exercise? If we find ourselves too exhausted after doing exercise, or there is dizziness, dyspnea, that is shortness of breath, or giddiness, that is the patient is feeling uncomfortable while doing exercise, that person should stop doing exercises immediately and consult the qualified clinician. Also, if we are starting a new exercises altogether for the first time, we should not start on our own. We should take the help of a qualified person who is trained in exercise programs. His help is mandatory. All these things must be taken care of when we are planning an exercise program, specifically in a pregnant lady. Any gynecological complications such as bleeding per vaginam or placenta previa or abortion in the previous pregnancy, all these are also need to be understood while exercise program is being designed. What has to be done post pregnancy? Post pregnancy, we have to start slow, because too early or too fast can lead to long term complications. So during first month, it's simple walking or stretching exercises are good enough. As the time advances, in second and third trimester, we can increase the intensity or and duration of the same type of exercises. By the end of 3 to 4 months, if there is no medical complication, we can go back to the routine exercise program which we were doing during or prior to the pregnancy. Why we are talking so much of exercise? What is the benefit of doing these exercises? We have seen, the various studies have shown, that when a person exercises regularly, specifically during pregnancy, the complications or the limitations which come with pregnancy, such as back pain, leg pain, the anxiety levels, the uncomfort level, the chances of induced labor, the duration of labor, all these come into our favorable situation. That is, the labor will be shorter, the chances of medically induced labor will also be reduced, the quantity of medicine will also be lesser when this exercise program is being taken regularly. So to conclude, we can say that a regular exercise of 30 to 45 minutes per day, moderate intensity, barring any medical condition, is a good recommendation in a pregnant lady for a healthy child and healthy mother. Thank you so much.